Hello, and welcome to a special episode of the Ultimate Torment Torture. And Vers?
I'm Sockerbagarn.
Wait, you are Sockerbagarn. Who are you?
I am. You're not. You're you.
No, I'm not you. I'm sorry. But
yeah. Why would I want... No.
Okay.
I just say what you're doing in this world. Come on.
So yeah, this is the first episode of the Ultimate Torment Torture, but with a little gimmick.
Yeah, he's playing on fast.
Yeah, on fast. So, this is a little harder. Monsters are much faster, they shoot at you. I mean, they never stop shooting at you, they don't... What's that?
Just look at this Hell Knight, he keeps blasting him.
He only stops when I'm shooting at it and he's getting pain states. But start shooting directly after that.
All the projectiles are also much faster, so you have less time to dodge fireballs and stuff.
Yes, but that also helps you in fighting. In fighting is quite different and fast. Like, I'm trying to infect these guys because if I did got into this room, I would have just died from the shotgunners.
Yes, you would.
I'm also playing as a scout class, so I've got less health, like you can see. 75 instead.
75 is max.
Yes, it's a max base health, so I can get more by using the medkits. I can go to 200 using Mega Sphere or health bonuses now.
Yeah. You're also a lot faster as a scout.
Yes. That's the point. Why not use the fastest class while the enemy is fast, so everything is like faster.
Fast.
Fast,
watch out, you don't get too fast.
Yes. Also, the melee monsters have like double walking and attack speed, but for the satyrs, you don't even see the difference.
Yeah, satyrs are worthless as usual.
Yes. They look even more worthless than before because, yeah.
Yeah, everything else is so fast, and they just keep lumbering on at a slow speed.
Yeah. And you will see later that the demons are really fast, the pinkies. But the other melee enemies don't have the properties to go so fast, dash fast. I had to add them myself to the code. Nothing much, just a little flag and that's it.
But at least the demons and the other melee creatures are fast.
Yeah.
The satyrs are slow though. Slow and weak.
Oh yes, slow and weak. And then... Come on! Fucking bastard. So yeah, in fast you have to get more careful, hide behind corners much more. And try to make monsters infect themselves. It's
yeah.
Very important.
Yeah, infighting is a really powerful tool in Doom.
Even more in fast.
Yes.
And here you can see that I can go only up to 165 because so far I only give 100.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to make these guys in fight by trying to lure them and to shoot themselves. Not working that well.
No, but at least you got that Mangabus.
I did.
It's not fun to fight them in close quarters on fast.
Sure.
Fire so many shots.
Yeah, and the thing with Mangabuses normally is they don't shoot much, or they have time before they shoot. So you can like stop them before or go before a wall, but in fast, no.
Yeah, nope. Don't try to pull any normal mancubus tricks on them. But they will just blast you.
Really.
You will die.
At least it's not Nightmare. I mean, in Nightmare, monsters will always spawn, and that's very bad.
That is very bad. Hey, didn't I kill those two Orcvites? Nope.
No, oh, they're back! Oops! One thing
I can prepare to kick your ass.
One thing I don't like about Nightmare 2 is that the respawn times are random. It's not like they will respawn in a set amount of time, but it's random between like 5 or 8 seconds and some minutes.
Yeah.
So stuff could respawn right before you, or like, it's very random and
At least you get double ammo, you would be really fucked.
Yeah, you really need that double ammo, but I don't see playing any of the harder squad like this one or Reveal or anything with in Nightmare, I mean.
No, things will just respawn before you clear the room.
Yeah. But for...
You just have to run in and grab the key here and run out, pretty much.
But for Doom 1 and Doom 2, it's kinda working. People...
Yeah, well, they are kinda easy too.
Yeah, they are already complex. But yeah, they removed the Nightmare game mode. I mean, the respawning enemies stuff in like erotic and accent. The monsters are still faster, but they don't respawn anymore.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
So yeah, like you can play in the harder difficulty without like the respawning bullshit and actually win the game without speedrunning. Yeah. Because speedrunning is not that
It's not fun if you can't win, really.
Yeah. You have to just run away, grab the key and exit. Not much fun.
Yeah, you would really be screwed if this was Nightmare. Grab the key and you can't run out and things will
stop spawning. Yeah, you can't run on because spawn stuff from behind you and yeah.
You get so stuck in this room.
And you can't get 100% kill in Nightmare. I hate it.
Oh, I thought you could get like more than 100.
Oh yeah, mate, it depends, it's counting. I'm not sure. I never really tried that, but...
Yeah, I don't think I play Nightmare on the original launcher. The one where Lost Souls don't count.
I think in the last level and map 30 of Doom 2, if you wait and kill more stuff as I spawn, you will get more than 100% kills.
Yeah, that's true.
But in Nightmare, I remember that. No idea. One fun fact too, the stairs I just got into before. There? Stairs, it's like the middle of the stairs teleport you to another area of the map.
It's excellent to teleport kill people.
Yeah, and in co-op that's a big issue because you will telefrag someone that's right in front of you. And that's
look at these guys, they're so fast.
Yeah, the demons. This is fast.
That is fast.
So yeah, demons are actually a little more dangerous in this mode. If you are cornered somewhere, they may be a big problem.
Yeah, if you use chainsaw, they can still attack you, right?
Yep.
I mean, normally when it's not fast, you would like stun lock them, what you call it. Their attack animation would be interrupted because they get hit. But in fast, they have time to bite you between the chainsaw attacks.
Yeah, so attacking enemies in melee in fast is really not a good idea.
Yes.
Just don't. More demons. So yeah, this guy is like kinda harmless in normal mode, but here I'm just backing up to be sure I won't get cornered and just rape to death.
Yeah. Definitely. Normally you can pretty much ignore them until they're right on top of you.
Yeah. But here, yeah. They just run so fast.
Yeah, here they are on top of you really, really fast.
Oh, and the thing I was talking about changing the code is that the improved demons, the one with like metal stuff on them, that have 2x the HP of normal demons, they don't run that fast, don't worry. Because the guy that makes the mod didn't put flags for fast, because he figured that no one would play fast. I guess. And that's pretty
Maybe.
True. Almost no one play, hard wads. Stuff is fast. And his homing guys are as annoying as ever. You have to get behind a wall if you want to get rid of his thrust.
Yeah, they have a quite tight cornering.
Yeah. And since they are slow moving, they can follow you even through corridors and stuff. Depending on how fast you move.
At least they're weak to kill.
Yeah. It's a good thing. But at least we're not seeing them in big area in another mod that we'll be seeing maybe later. You have some of these enemies in open areas and big caverns, and it's extremely annoying.
Yeah. That sounds pretty rough.
Yeah, it is. That mod is knee deep in gzdoom, by the way.
Oh, I play that.
Yeah.
I just didn't remember it, I guess.
Knee deep in gzdoom is pretty good. It uses some monsters that are in this mod as well, because Torment Torture, the guy that made this mod, worked on it as well.
Oh, hey, autosave.
Yeah, autosave. Yeah. I know I'm just going to run past the invincible Arachnotrons and Spider Mastermind because, yeah.
Yeah, those are real gun Arachnotrons.
Yeah, I don't get it. If you don't move that fast into the room, you're just going to be obliterated. That would be bad.
That would be bad.
And yeah, they are trying to kill themselves, but they obviously can't.
Damn, that's an evil machine.
Yeah, and
yes, very evil machine, good job.
And one stupid thing about that event with the button, if there are other enemies than the two Arachnotrons and the Spider Mastermind in the room, or even you, or any other players, they don't die. Only the Spider Mastermind and the two Arachnotrons, Raygun Arachnotrons, die.
Yeah, that's kind of boring.
Yeah, that's not fun.
I mean, they probably do that because the Mastermind and the Arachnotrons are invulnerable, but...
Yeah, it's a way the game works. You can do damage in one area, like Half-Life, for instance.
Could spawn a bunch of rockets, maybe?
Yeah, that'd be nice. Nice idea, but you already dug that in the next map.
Oh yeah. Nice. Well, you could hide it with all the white flash thing.
You wasted air explosions.
Yeah, well, it's an evil machine, of course there should be explosions.
Oh yeah, they could spawn invisible projectiles, but whatever, yeah. That's true.
Well, it doesn't matter much, it's just one room.
Yeah, meanwhile I'm just like running around and dodging movement balls. So your open areas in fast when you have revenants in front of you, it's even harder.
Yeah, of course.
In corridors and stuff you can easily dodge them or hide them. Yes, you can get surprised like this ball that I almost got in my face. Whatever. So I'm not sure if I would do every map in fast, because some of them are pretty long, and doing like 30 or 40 minutes straight without saving in fast is not that easy, actually.
Oh, that would be hard. You'd have to retry a lot of times.
Yes.
Take forever.
I think I can do the second episode though. I tried before and almost did it.
That's good.
The boss is kinda deadly on fast though.
Yeah. They use that exploding attack too much. You'd be quite surrounded by flames.
And quite dead.
Which is never a good game thing, of course.
And I would have to cheese some parts, like the part outside. Like, I would have to snipe everything. Because if I don't, yeah, I would be in serious trouble. And that may be boring to watch, I'm not sure. This one is pretty okay on fast.
Yeah.
You will see about the boss. And yeah, when I did this video with subtitles, I failed to use the bonus weapon we get later on. Properly. This time, I'm going to reuse it and not shoot myself in the face with it. That's too bad we don't see that weapon much. We only see it two times, I think, in the world mode.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's boring. I like it. It's a big explosion.
It's a big explosion. It's pretty and boom. It's
pretty and everything dies.
Yeah. Gibbs. And blood everywhere.
The big spinning thing in the middle. Why is there so many spinning things in this mod anyway?
Yeah, no idea. And the I'm waiting for the stuff to spawn there.
Uh-oh.
Problem. So yeah, for that part, I'm trying to lure them out. I'm going to make it soon. Yeah, now. I'm not sure, but I think the Cyber Demon is going to do that one.
I think so too. Uh-oh. He got pissed at you.
Yeah, I just said that and... He heard it. So you have to watch out for every enemy in fast. In normal, they may like spend like 20 seconds without shooting once, but this in fast, I never will. Yeah, he lost. Two barons left.
And they died too.
Yep.
Surprisingly.
And some more jumping shit.
Oh, you almost had it.
Jumping in Doom is pretty weird, but there are map packs that are launched only with jumpings and servers on Skulltag. That's quite popular, actually, some of them.
Oh. It's kind of strange jumping on those sprites.
Yeah.
I think you mentioned that last time.
I think I did, yeah.
I mean, they have no depth. You stand on, like, pixel.
No, so actually that's depth. It's like sprites like that.
Well,
it's not a
visual depth, that is.
Yeah, you don't see it, but it's like a square. Like you're jumping on a box, but it doesn't look like. And then, here I'm showing that demons can actually hit you fast.
Yeah, actually hit you. That never happens really in normal.
No.
You just take one small step back and they miss.
Exactly. It's even a good idea to get melee run from them so they like attack you and stop moving.
Yeah.
But here, no. I also changed the kamikaze guys so they run faster. But they don't have much time to run there. Okay, so this time I'm not using the weapon in this place. I will be keeping for the boss.
I don't know if they trapped you or you trapped them, they died too faster.
Okay, so that's the boss area again.
Yeah, you know what happens.
I don't need the ammo, but I'm taking everything anyway, that's for no reason.
Well, you get used to that.
Yeah, that stuff. You've got to take it. Can't resist.
If you don't pick up rockets, you're just stupid.
So this part is pretty hard, but yeah, I'm going to show that this weapon can like one-shot kill one of these guys. And if you don't do that and then kill the next one, cross my gun, you're just going to get as well.
Yeah.
And what happened to me, like in two runs, I got into this part and I died there.
You were close to dying this time too. Took a bunch of damage.
Yeah, I did. But I make it out in the end, so I guess that's the end of this video.
Yep. Oh, you missed one.
No. We'll be seeing you next time.